Mute.
Mute. So these are the Triangle Esprit Towers. Now, I did the Boreas, then I did the Borea. Did I do the Borea Towers? I did a set of Boreas. It was not great. But mostly Triangle makes good stuff. And so then it was like, all right, we got you. We got this. We hook you up. And so these arrived, and they're not very big, these towers. I'm keeping the covers on while we walk back and forth. And I've just messaged the distributor, literally texted him before this review, because I'm like, I don't know how much these cost. They're not on Adorama as of this moment, but I'm ready for the review. And you think that being ready for the review means you know all the facts, and that's not how Zeos works. Is it, Chewbacca? No. What works is the sun is going down. I want a little bit extra light in this room, and let's fucking do this. So, wallpaper available in the description. Let's talk about Triangle Tower speakers, because this is my first set. And it makes sense that these are the 570s, the little baby, little tiny baby JBLs. And you can see they're up on some bricks to make them even a little bit taller. And these are a little bit taller than that. But the actual dimensions, like, look. That thing looks fat compared to this. I'll uncover them in a second. I want to point out the fact that as far as WAF goes, which for all intents and purposes, Chewbacca is my WAF. Right, baby? You my wife now? We're going to run away to Cancun and get married for reals. If someone does that stupid fan fiction. Ugh. There's something about a gloss. And I don't know if I can't have anything. There's nothing here to reflect off of onto the TV. There's something about a gloss white speaker that is just like, oh, Jesus Christ. And Triangle is very good at this too. Hi, well, there's a reflection. Getting the cover material to be opaque, I guess would be the word. So it's white and it doesn't look like thin, bad white. They put it up, they doubled it up. I'm assuming that you're only gonna have these covers on, however, when you have very, very picky guests, or if you're trying to like, make your living room look a little bit more fancy, because when you take them off, oh God, to my knees. Drop to my knees, which is where I probably have to be for this review. Because remember, they're really short speakers. I don't mind when I'm sitting on the love seat here. I wasn't actually attempting to touch you, Chewbacca. You were just taking advantage of me pointing at the couch. So they're still a little bit low, but I wouldn't like concern myself because I did put the tweeter, and can we point to the tweeter? You can actually see me in there. Hi, that's me. The tweeter is the same tweeter from the other Esprits, the Cometes. These are the Esprit Gaia Easy, and I'll know that. We'll move down because just like anything that's lovely in this world, you start at the top, ladies, and you work your way down. So we've got that tweeter, which looks like it would hurt, but it don't. We've got a artificial, it's just a pointy dust cover, with a paper surround on a paper white cone mid-range. And then we come down here and we have reversed rolled rubber surrounds on polymer mid-range for two other 5 1/4s. This is a very, very narrow speaker. I'm doing this like on the beach, sax on the beach. It's a very narrow speaker. It doesn't take up a lot of your visual space. And when you have the covers on, it's very like, holy shit, there's just white monoliths in the room making this sound. When you take them off, it's sort of like, oh, Jesus Christ. The details, like the circles getting cut off because they literally would touch the edges if they kept going. And then down here, I'm going to take my camera off to show you this because it's blatantly a fucking mirror. There's a Chewbacca probably sneezed on it. There is a glass, a metal reflective surface. Hi, everyone. There's my GoPro with my custom putty mount to stop reverberations. Or it says Esprit Gaia Easy Triangle Triangle. And then you have your port at the bottom. Yeah, that's weird because literally that's my carpet. I could see my carpet here because anything that goes into it is gonna be reflected, not by a glass mirror, but like a damn metal mirror. So, oh, speaking of glass, we gotta talk. I gotta go back down to the ground again, don't I? Fuck. Right, back down to the ground. another thing that this speaker does, I'm going way down, we're way down here. This stabilization plate, like the actual base plate, do you see the logo? See it breaking? Because that's glass. The whole thing is glass. Oh my God. I just want you to get, I want to give you like the flavor of these speakers, because I've done other, like the JBLs behind it. Yeah, they're towers and they're great. I got them for $400. And as soon as we find out from Frank how much these cost, I'll be able to actually make an assessment of, I'm gonna have to guess, aren't I? I'm gonna say $2,500 for the pair. That's my Zeos, Z Reviews professional opinion is what these should cost. If they're $2,800, I'll give them a little bit. If they're like $1,700, it's like, oh shit. Because they put out, this is not a big speaker. This 5 1/4 with that tweeter. It's a nice, smooth speaker. Gets good sound, good sounding like vocals, but it's not gonna blow you away. But then the rest of it happens and you get kicked in sort of like the face. Just a little bit in the face. So, but in like the most beautiful way. That's what you're looking at. What a tower speaker should be is basically a bookshelf speaker, a finely tuned bookshelf speaker that has no need to put out low end because the rest of it is for putting out the low end. Now I actually do have a triangle sub in the closet. It's currently off. If we start shuffling around, we should have to unmute this. It's very quiet. These might work as a near field speaker. Just saying. I mean, you're probably not going to Indian sit style on the floor, but you know what? I would not be I would not be opposed to people who just bought these in like a super minimalist environment and just cross their legs, which I'm going to have a very hard time. Like I can't do the thing where I put my leg up on the other one. But if this was your, like I'm going to enjoy things now and you have just a spirit Gaia's just there and just sort of like let it happen. I pulled them out. They were pushed back a little further. And as I pulled them out further and further into the room, I realized that, oof, get closer to me. I want these closer. I don't recommend something, like this is a decent tower, a very decent tower. I wouldn't give it a review. It wasn't at least a decent tower, but it's not a very big tower. So it does have low end. It's kicking, it'll kick some snot. Skip a... 3, 4. Skip. See, I ask for music that shows off the low end, and all I keep getting is music that's showing off the highs. That tweeter, that mid-range, completely separate in a three-way from that, which is the bass driver, which is, there's been several towers I've reviewed recently, and I've sort of complained. And I could even look at the JBL 570s next to it and sort of complain about those because those have two drivers, but they both do the same job, and then everything else is up to the horn. So where's your mid-range coming from? It's coming from there. Where's your low-end coming from? It's coming from there. The same spot. When you can break it apart and do treble, tweeter, mid-range vocals higher up, and then this is just that lovely, warm, flowing bazookas, big bazookas of just fill in the low end without fucking with the rest of it. It's great. Oh, but we're back to the fucking tweeters again. Come on, something. Oh God. I know, I can't wait. I would love to just play music. Why can't I do reviews where I just play music? Can I do that on Pornhub? Should I move there? I don't know. You guys tell me. Think about the wallpapers I could use. So I've been using these speakers for a couple weeks now, as this is my like little sunroom theater thing where I escape from the echo of the big room, you know, that with the vertical TV that's floating around in there with like mono. And this is like where I live in this room. I use these speakers more than any speakers, even having the Bucharts downstairs. In fact, these speakers, let's see, it was Bucharts up here, then I changed it out with the 570s, and I was like, oh, yeah. Then I changed out the 570s, or at least moved the 570s over, and went, okay, it's time for me to assess these triangles. And I'm not sure if I'm going to even bother bringing them down the basement. If this video cuts off right now, and then we're down the basement, then, I mean, then I'm going to do the sound up here, and it's... I feel like it's wrong to put these speakers in the basement. They're too pretty. It's almost inconsequential how good they sound because they look like they look. And they cover everything they need to cover. Do they have enough low end ZO so they don't need a sub? Curb your enthusiasm. They work. They work.
Rock and roll is dead and pop is in it. Why not discover the excitement of the science of music yourself at Synth and Son?
They do what a triangle speaker I've expected to do. They give you somehow incredibly accurate, almost nose-bleedingly good highs, but they never hurt. Imaging, stellar. I'd actually, if I move the JBLs out, I could bring these out and I guess fucking move them. There's no point in talking about things. This is the review. Oh God, the glass. There is a very strange sensation, by the way, about screwing, because you come separate. You have to actually screw. Wait. Screwing the glass. I'm out of context already. There's a string. Is light going to help us? This room does not have enough light to do. I need to put like track lights in or something. If I'm going to continue to do stuff like this, maybe like a track light there just shining forward. Then I'd have a lot of shadows. I don't know. I'm always concerned about how I make a space better to film in. Oh God, I did it again. Where I banged the glass. Having to assemble the bottom of these was one of the most harrowing experiences because they're too pretty to like just flip upside down and put the shiny, you know, put this insanely shiny, perfect surface on a floor. No, not even a rug. I wouldn't even lean them on the rug. I got a pair of my pants and I folded them and I put it down and then I turned it upside down and then I had to put the rubber gaskets on to screw those glass shelves, the glass pedestals onto the bottom. And I'm just like, oh God, please don't crack. I don't think they're gonna. They're like real fucking heavy duty. But the fact that, like, you'll never notice it. Like, you're walking along and it's like, all right, there's a base on these. It's a shiny plastic base. No, motherfuckers, it's glass. It's fucking 3/8 of an inch tempered glass. Or 1 centimeter tempered glass. Take your pick. They look... Oh, let's now that I've got them separated a little bit for this particular part of the review, let's just have a seat. In my usual area...
Going hang gliding.
Pearl Jam.
What kind of rat bastard psychotic would play that song right now at this moment?
Yeah. I'm the kind of rat bastard psychotic that would do that. Oh, Billy Joel, I Go to Extremes, the live, never released, My Lives, Disc 3. Obviously, it was never released until now. Now it's released. Now you got to take away never released for the next time you release it. This setup, by the way, I want to give you a little background. TV, my 43-inch 4K that I used to use in my sim racing cockpit, my old home theater PC that ran my living room. We've got it plugged in fiber optic to the VMV D1 DAC, which is what the remote control I'm using. For next track, last track, I have it programmed into a FLIRC. We are using the Emotiva. Because here's, if I had to say there's a bottleneck in this system, I'm saying it's the Emotiva monoblocks. They're a little sterile. Because they're Class D and they put out a lot of power, but usually I listen to every speaker in like some form or another on those monoblocks first. In fact, these monoblocks were in the main living room chamber, the main great room chamber forever. And I moved them in here because it makes perfect sense since I'm trying to go for a very, very small, compact little setup for just testing and moving that I do that. And even on what is considered to me a sterile like sound, like as clean as you can get, as clean as you can get, these speakers still scream triangle juiciness. Yeah, no, I'm gonna call their cost to $2,500 and we'll see if I get a, oh, there you go. Oh, it's pretty fun. The centers have a 1300 for the sub, $26.95, oh, that's for the, wow, let's see. 2400 for gloss black and white, or 2150. Wow. Man, am I good. 2400 for the pair. I called it. 2400 for a pair, and I think they're only on dealers. I'll get you some links. And then if you want the ones that are not gloss white or black, trust me. If you have a wife, or you have a very, very shiny, loving husband, what was it, Vinyl Daddy from that game that Pasta was playing? If you have a Vinyl Daddy or a woman who wants, like, beautiful things, only beautiful things in the house, spend the $2,400, get the gloss white ones. Oh, my God. And then $2,150 for the standard ash, black ash ones, or walnut. Walnut look good. Wow, that's center channel. I'm gonna be a little bit more harsh in the center channel than I am with these, because these are towers and they're performing. The center channel that matches these is a little bit, well, in the great room it's lacking, but here. Like, that's it. That's all you need to hear. And you're going to ask me to compare to the JBL 570s, which are behind them, which are like 400, 800, 1600, like six times less cost. I think these do the highs better. I think the 570s actually might do the lows better, which is strange to say, but you have to think about it this way. This is a front ported unit. And I always find front ported units don't throw the low end as much. A lot of times a unit like this that has rear port will just, you know, beat the air into the back and you get this wash of low end towards the front of you. But front ported units, which is what these are, will sort of just, it'll just sound more coherent. So it's not as bombastic in the bass, but it's more coherent. These sound like a $2,500 set of towers. Now that I know the price, my brain was, you don't believe me, you think that I'm lying, but I literally was like, holy shit, I have no idea how much these cost. I just agreed to review them because I knew they were this line. $2,500 with this finish, or $2,400 with this finish, and less than that in a lesser finish, they're, how do I say the word effeminate without offending anybody? They're a bit teeny tiny. Like, I took them out and I was like, oh, I'm getting triangle towers. And I was like, oh, these are minuscule. But I've learned that when I had them, like, I literally, where these JBLs are is where I normally keep the JBLs. I was just able to fit these very thin, fucking handsome ass speakers right between it. Just right between it. And just plug the amplifiers into these instead of those. And just, oh, cream. Cream came out. Now that they're in front of them, and wait, we're not even. I have to fix this. I need to watch Cobra Kai seasons 1, 2, and 3. So I'm gonna make sure the speakers are good. And I'm like cockeyed now. I could probably put together an entire compilation video of just me adjusting speakers, because it'll take like 15 fucking hours. So yeah, as we sit here, Mako? Is that Mako? Or is Mako the one who's clothes fall off? Cyclops Gorilla. With Cyclops Gorilla wallpaper, these are very delicate. That's the word. I'm not going to go with the defense. They're delicate. These are delicate speakers. I think they're probably the only high-end, higher, because it's not even high-end, like a $2,500 for a pair, and this is 2020, this is 2021 Zeos. So his whole brain patterns, his chemistry has changed from like what was affordable then to what is affordable now. Not just for me, but like how much stuff I've seen where I could actually put into concept, oh, $2,400 for a beautiful set of towers. Because really, they are probably one of the most pretty and delicate sounding. Like I could rock out on it. We could. Oh, I have to unmute it. If I can't, unpause it and mute it. That's gonna get pulled. You can just hear from everywhere. You can just hear from everywhere that, oh fuck, that is someone violently playing a violin. That's just what comes out of these speakers. These are speakers designed to play... I keep checking behind me in case Chewbacca's there. I don't want to sit on her. These are speakers designed to play... Who the fuck is that? Shostakovich Dmitri. Dmitri, Shostakovich. This is him. This is his shit. Next. And then Korn, of course, comes on. And I never thought I would say, oh, that Korn sounds absolutely divine on these speakers, but... Yeah, Korn sounds divine on these speakers. You're paying for the triangle uppers, and you're getting the triangle lowers, and then you're also getting that application of fucking beauty, where these speakers will fit into any... Like, I could put these in my bathroom. Like, I have a marble bathroom, and it's like, oh, that's beautiful. Put some flowers next to it. Like, oh, ah, oh, ah. Oh. This is the triangle I want to review. I don't want to review, like, the low-end, entry-level triangle. I wish these were self-powered and they had the same Alara DSP corrections in them. Because I know that, oh my god, I know what that would do. What's this now? Dead mouse? I'm going to give it a second. Let it get to the part where it looks interesting. Then I will unmute it on that $1,000 DAC and let the individual monoblocks come to life and express their dead mouse to me. Please!
In the end, we are nowhere. Sleepless and still and tight. Ready, we set to fall asleep.
You know, these are Triangle Tower speakers. They might be the babiest of the Triangle Tower speakers. I'll give you that. These are the babiest. But they good. If you have the JBL 570s, you're fine. If you have the 580s, the 590s, you have the Borea Towers. I don't think I got to play with the Borea Towers. But I don't know how to think about them now that I did those bigger Boreas that I didn't like. I just didn't like them. They had no low end. These at least still can deliver the low end. Even if it's not like room shaking, like the floor under my feet is vibrating. And this is not exactly like this is not Sophie Needs a Ladder. Because this is Sophie Needs a Ladder. I could actually see all the drivers moving and I click it up. I keep clicking up the volume and just, it doesn't bother me. There's never that ramp up like the Klipsch Heresies have, like when you put the volume up and then the treble becomes too much because the horns are more efficient than the, everything's balanced. We're in a very balanced speaker here as we lose the light, as the sun fades over the horizon, as Rick Sanchez grieves with his friend Bird Person over the loss of his wife with Squanchy in the background. We where I'm sitting, my eye level is about to the very top of the speaker.
Yeah, fill me up.
Pasta, what are you up to? That's Pasta. She's locked in Canada. Does anybody know how to smuggle a human being? Please say so in the comments. I wish they were a little bit taller. Like if I took the JBLs off the bricks and I put these on the bricks, they'd be perfect. But any taller than that, and you're gonna have a little bit of weirdness, especially with a bass that big. You're gonna have to make a bigger bass to make the stability go up. I'm giving these a yes. I'm giving these very much a yes, and thank God the triangle is back now. Holy shit. I will probably try these with the tube amps that were sent to me, because those are like $2,700 a pair, which is not bad for tube amps made in Turkey, I guess. Man, the imaging. Here's the thing. I'm almost doing this review bad, because I know what this sounds like from previous triangles. That fucking weird pointy tweeter that looks like it's gonna hurt, but it doesn't. And I know exactly how well it images, and I've been using them for weeks. This is why sometimes when I take weeks to like assess a product, it's bad. Because I just get so used to how good it is, I'm just like, But yeah, it's as good as it's been. But you people on the internet haven't heard these already? Why haven't you heard these? And I have to keep like reminding myself, oh, you have no idea what these sound like. You haven't been sitting here watching YouTube videos, listening to music, playing Spotify. You haven't done any of those things. Ah, when Golden One sends you, you know, a track in Telegram, you're like, here, listen to this. And I'm like, ooh, that sounds lovely. This is what I'm assessing that on. So it's like, it's like when you ask a race car driver, how was the race? And he's like, it was all right. Because he just does racing all the time. This is as you ask Zias, how are these $2,400 fucking trial towers? Oh, they're all right. Meanwhile, to anyone else, spending a couple hours with these would be like the fucking greatest example of like, holy shit, the music was in my eyes. And then the bass was filled my stomach with butterflies. So I can't. That's why when the Gold Planner thing happened, like it made me remember. It was Madonna's Like a Virgin, but not Madonna's Like a Virgin. It was Steve Buscemi explaining Madonna's Like a Virgin from the beginning of Reservoir Dogs. It was that. So these aren't redefining the speaker for me. They don't redefine it. They sound exactly as good as I think a $2,500 speaker should sound. The next white pair of speakers I get, white tower speakers, is going to be the Bucart A700s. Now, those are not as affordable as these at $2,500. But I am kind of expecting those to redefine what I consider speakers are capable of doing. We'll see. I don't know, 18 hertz in the low end sounds like a fucking challenge. We'll see. But for now, for right now, if you have a posh Upper West Side, you know, apartment in Manhattan, and you're just like, I want speakers, Zios, that don't suck, that look fan-fucking-tastic, and that I actually perform. Like not sucking is like that's minimum, and then actual performing is like a next step up. And if we go into my closet, come in my closet, you can see I have the Thesis 320 subwoofer, which is a little baby sealed sub in there, which I have currently turned off. And I was, because at the volumes I'm playing it now for this particular examination is a little bit more elevated. And therefore, what's playing right now? Hold on. If I play this at like listening levels, which is this, you don't get quite a lot of low end out of it. They're very, very polite speakers. That's another thing. This review is me gearing up to do my review. I started off, I'm a little bit rocky, at least I showed you the front. Now I'm getting into the actual nitty gritty of it towards the end, which is why people who skip the end of the videos miss out. These speakers are very polite and very capable and can do low end, but usually that low end requires you to like, well, they're 5 1/4. So the problem with a passive speaker, and this is why I'm always gonna think powered speakers are going to be the better speaker, is that when you lower the volume on a passive speaker, well, that's it. You're shit out of luck. You don't have enough power to drive those drivers hard enough to give you the low end. You don't get it. On a powered speaker, you lower the volume and it knows you've lowered the volume and it goes, okay, we're not getting a lot of volume signal to go loud, but we don't have any low end. So we're just going to push these a little bit harder because I'm in control or they're in control. Here, it's going to only be able to react to how much power you're giving it. You want low end, you got to give it the power to produce low end. That's a thing. There is I will explain this a couple times over the next few weeks, probably. Need some artwork there, number one. There is a perfect volume for every headphone and speaker on the earth. Perfect. Where you give it enough power, and then the crossover lights up, and everything, the amount of air it moves, corresponds with how the drivers are tuned, and everything is perfect. And you know what? They don't tell you what that is. So these speakers are absolutely gentlemen. In fact, that might even be a benefit for you if you're living in that midtown apartment in Manhattan and you have neighbors that are out of their minds because they're not taking their meds. You can just lower this. You get a little bit less low end, but yet you still get the clarity and detail and separation and all the imaging that you could ever want. And then when Haywire kicks up, it's like, all right. There's some low end there, but it's not like shaking the house. But then you turn it up when the neighbors are gone or you don't give a fuck. Now is when these speakers are like, oh Jesus, These are high. These are probably the definition of a hi-fi speaker. Nothing into the $10,000 range. Even the Bukart, like $4,500. Like you could spend $2,400 or $2,100, which is not a little bit, but it might be able to accommodate that and a couple saved paychecks here and there, and you'll have hi-fi. You are hi-fi now. As far as power requirements, it's a little hard for me to judge. Those are like 300 watts per channel, and I'm just going off the negative decibels of this. This, by the way, is Haywire Dichotomy Soft Mix, in case you're wondering. Yeah, no, these are the hi-fi equivalent of a tower speaker. I don't not love the 570s. I'm probably going to put them back. In fact, the 570s, if I had to give them a win somewhere in the category where the David and Goliath, those probably do this sound better still because horn, and where these are much more accurate, straight-laced, perfectly, here is the sound of this flute. I hope your eyeballs can enjoy it because I'm going to put it right the fuck there. Konosuba OST, by the way. Yeah, no, that's that. There's your hi-fi. The 570s are fucking rocking party speakers compared to these. More low end, bigger staging. But these are higher quality. And they look it too. And then when you go and you put these back on, you know, oh shit. The mother-in-law and father-in-law are gonna be here. I don't want them to think I'm some, you know, person who doesn't have class. Are you gonna stick? Boom. Magnets, by the way. Then they just become these white fucking, that's it. I've actually, they look like when you use an eraser, a whiteout pen. I've whiteouted the JBL Studio 570s. It's like, yeah, they're there, but are they there? Definitely gonna get a copyright thing for that, which is probably why we won't see ads on this, which is why I thank you when you join my Patreon and Subscribestar. Guaranteeing I don't have to push ads and everything, even though I do sometimes just to see if I get more people going towards YouTube, like if I have higher numbers. I don't know, I'm testing some shit out. Anyway, these speakers are the best place I could link. I'll link to Adorama. If they add them to Adorama, there'll be a link to that. I will link to wherever he says you can get them. I'll link to Emotiva. If I don't even know if they sell those amps anymore. I know that DAC exists. What else do you guys want? JBL speakers? You got it. You got it! There's still a bit of echo from in this room out there. And if I close these doors, they're glass doors, so it doesn't really help with the reflections. But I'll eventually get to all these rooms. Still don't know what this room is. I think this room's purpose is literally this, though. Because, I mean, that's my office. Upstairs is probably going to be the exercise area. Exercise and chill. Because there's no reason to go up to an area where you only exercise. That'll make you hate it. But if you exercise and chill, then you're right. Anyway, that's it for this review. So feel free to click links and follow it. The sun has now gone down almost fully. What's on, John Williams? Slave Children Crusade. Amazing. From Temple of Doom. More John Williams. See right there. There's just enough low end to be like, oh, these are not a bookshelf speaker. That reached down there. It's not rocking the block with the what is this? Jaws, Shark Attack? Yeah, no, I feel fancy as fuck. I feel fancy af with these in the house. That's all you gotta know. I think I have, if I ever have a woman over here eventually, she'll be like, oh, damn. I feel like I should take my clothes off or something. And that's what these speakers do. So, Patreon and Subscribestar. $5 a month lets you see these reviews early and participate in the yard sales. We'll see what I could work out with them. Maybe if I can steal these from them or get them for a low enough price, I'll throw them in the yard sale. I have all the original boxes. Shipping is a fucking nightmare. I hate shipping. But anyway, most of the units I am done reviewing at the end of the month, I will throw into the yard sale from the 1st to the 10th of every month. Name your own price, free shipping United States, third shipping international. I pay 2/3 shipping international, you pay 1/3 shipping. And then if you want to talk to me, like that, like the people that do, $10 Telegram chat. We'll put you on my phone, and you can ask me any questions you want. And hopefully, not just me, everyone in the chat can help you answer your questions. If you have problems with monetarily, don't spend the 10. Just don't. Just fucking don't. Because as soon as you spend that 10, you've spent $1,000. Someone in there, it's not just me. Like, I'm here to help save you money, all right? But the people in that $10 Telegram chat, they're the devils. And they're going to put that thought in your head that you obviously need R2R DAX, or you need this sort of room treatment, or you need, they usually don't go into like expensive cables and stuff. Although Skedder, who makes Viking Weave cables, is literally in there. Like, he's one of the first patrons. So he's like, yeah, I make cables like this. Do you want one? They're a couple $100. But I mean, you know, you can have one because you're my buddy now. Like, fuck. And everyone's got a goddamn scable and they're so nice. Anyway, I'm done. He doesn't make speaker cables yet. Thankfully, save some money on that. Classy fucking Marilyn Manson. Anyway, I'm done. Sound demo, which I'm not sure if it's going to happen up here or if I will have to bring it eventually down the basement just to record it properly. But that'll be down there. And maybe I'll give some more insight in the sound demo for how these sound in a much more environmentally friendly environment. Well, I'm in a loop. Yeah, anyway. Wallpaper, speakers, music, cats. See you tomorrow for the sound demo.